Hello, good morning, and welcome to another edition of Safety Team, your number one TV station that keep us safe, that think about the safety from the management and staff of Delta Broadcasting Service. This morning, we're going to be looking at fever in a particular way. We're talking about fever when it comes to children. The period is still in port, and schools are beginning to resume, and we felt that this is the time where children are mostly exposed to fever itself. Fever is usually associated with other type of infection, which are slow onset. It means they come up gradually without you the morning knowing. For infants and children, most times it is very dangerous because the child has no way to explain to you what he or she is feeling. But when you find out that your child is looking a bit weak, if your child is becoming to display very weak, probably the child is very smart. You should first of all suspect that child is developing fever, because fever in itself also fights against the immune system. The immune system that keeps the child active and make the child be able to fight against infection. The fever starts affecting the immune system and that child becoming a bit weak. And sometimes the child could be drowsy in nature. And the most significant one that we see every day is that the child develops seizure in the hand of the mother. All these are just common signs which you could see, and you observe that the child is suffering from high fever. What do we do as parents when we discover this kind of weakness in our child, in our kids? The first is for us, as usual, run quickly to your first aid kit. We all know that we as parents should have first aid kit in the home. You should run to your first aid kit like this and quickly look for probably the thermometer. Almost everybody has a thermometer at home. If you're a mother and you don't have a thermometer in your house, probably you're not doing the right thing. Thermometer is one of the cheapest thing you could get in the pharmaceutical shop for you to be able to check your child if your child is suffering from fever or display any sign of fever. When you get your thermometer like this, you quickly get your baby, you could get your infant per se, and try to check the temperature of the infant. The two ways in which you can check the temperature of your infant: you either put the thermometer by the armpit and close it very well, and close it very well for a period of about a minute. For the digital thermometer, it's going to beep once you finish reading, but for the analytical one, it's not going to beep. You just need to stay for about a minute. If you are not comfortable putting it in the armpit, you could also put it in the mouth of the infant. You know, infants in nature, they like anything sucking. So once you put it in the tongue of the infant, they keep sucking or sucking until it beats up like this. When it beats up for about a minute, you discover and you find out from the reading that the thermometer is reading above 37 degrees. You should suspect that baby is already suffering from high fever. Always know that thermometer will come in two ways. It might be reading a degree centigrade, and when you have 47 and above, you know you suspect high fever. If you are using the one that is read inferior, if the one is read inferior, once it reads 99 points, anything above 99, you suspect that the child is suffering from high fever. And if you don't manage it immediately, it could lead to seizure. For the first aid, normally, you know, we usually recommend that in first aid, you have to fight down the emergency situation. If the child is undergoing seizure, please, this time you need to call your medical personnel or probably run the child to the hospital. If the temperature is so high, exceeding 47 degrees, you know that paracetamol is a first aid drug that you can see everywhere. For infants and children, you could just administer 5 ml of the syrup immediately. What it will do is going to help put down the temperature of that baby almost immediately. However, for you who might be a neighbor and the mother don't know about all this, you could spike a sign of seizure when the child is undergoing seizure. These have taken the life of so many children around the world. And so if you find out that the child is suffering from seizure as a result of high fever, all you need to do is to get a bowl of water and get a piece of cloth like this. You could have a piece of cloth like this, dip in water, press off the water from it, and you start damping. We call it co-sponging. You co-sponge the baby from the head, because the reaction that leads to seizure is the excessive temperature around the brain. So you start co-sponging the baby from the head. Immediately you start co-sponging the baby like this, you discover that the baby will stop automatically its seizure. You start from the head, immediately the head temperature is going down. Ordinarily, before you finish with the head, this cloth will be off. Immediately you find a high temperature on the blood, dip it back into the water, press up again, squeeze up the water, and continue from the chest region, because this is another region where the child has vital organs that could be reacting. So you just continue to do this until the child, you could sponge the entire body of the child from head to leg completely. You start again from the head, continuously until the child stop seizure and the child temperature become very normal. Normally when you finish post washing and you take off your thermometer again, if you check the child temperature, you discover it's going to be reading between 35 and 34 degrees. Once it reads like that, know that the temperature is already coming down. You administer paracetamol if the need be, and then take the child immediately to the hospital. High temperature in children don't just surface if there is no associated illness. If you don't get that child to the hospital, it will come and come and come again. And so many kids have died from such a situation. These are just a few steps you need to take when a child is developed an high fever. We said one, if the temperature is not going to seizure, you should just administer paracetamol, then take the child to the hospital. But once it has developed to seizure, you just get a bowl of water and a cloth and co-sponge the baby. Once you co-sponge that baby and the baby's temperature is down, you give the baby paracetamol, 5 mL of paracetamol, and then take the baby straight to the hospital so that the associated ailments could be treated immediately. I be your guide, Paul ORUKAMAYAN, on safety until we meet again next time.